I can't figure this out, Dr. Oz. You've been trained in science-based medicine. Quote, I've got the number one miracle in a bottle to burn your fat. It's raspberry ketone. Quote, Garcinia cambogia, it may be the simple solution you've been looking for to bust your body fat for good. I don't get why you need to say this stuff, because you know it's not true.
Senator Casco, I do think if I can just...
And when you call a product a miracle, and it's something you can buy, and it's something that gives people false hope, I just don't understand why you need to go there.
Well, if I could, my job, I feel, on the show is to be a cheerleader for the audience. When they don't think
they have hope. Bravo, Mehmet. Bravo. The world-renowned cardiothoracic surgeon trades his blue nitrile gloves for decidedly unsterile pom-poms. Back in Gaffney, we used to call Oz the Wizard. That rarest combination of charisma and credibility that could charm the plaque off a coronary. But now, the good Senator Clare has turned the world's attention on the quack behind the curtain.
I mean, I've tried to really do a lot of research in preparation for this trial, and the scientific community is almost monolithic against you.
I love that woman like a hematologist loves blood. She's right. Physicians are a proud people. It is their strength and their great weakness. Long have they suffered at the hands of bureaucrats who wouldn't know a stethoscope from a toilet plunger, but this.
Green coffee and extract.
To suffer at the hands of one of their own. Intolerable. Hell hath no fury like a physician forced to spend the first 5 minutes of a 6-minute visit undoing the nefarious teachings of Dr. Jack and his magic beans. But I don't hold doctors blameless in this disorganized squabbling. Blindly accepting the powerlessness handed to them, but Oz had true power.
So why, when you have this amazing megaphone and this amazing ability to communicate, why would you cheapen your show by saying things like that?
Why, Claire? Because long ago, Oz chose money over power. Money is the gaudy Bentley in the physician's parking lot, depreciating from the second it's purchased. Power is a megaphone blaring into 40 million homes, amplified by an unshakable credibility predicated on a truth that you have no dog in this fight beyond what's best for your patient. Oz betrayed his sacred duty. He squandered his immense power to hawk pseudo-scientific snake oil to vulnerable housewives for the sake of ratings. Unforgivable. Give me 5 minutes with Oz's megaphone and I'll have raised the vaccination rate to 105%, cured childhood obesity, and largely eliminated annoying acne. If only I had Oz's.
I know you feel that you're a victim, but sometimes conduct invites being a victim. And I think if you would be more careful, maybe you wouldn't be victimized quite as frequently.
Senator Casco, those topics you mentioned...
Like taking candy from a pediatrician. Yes. Get me Oprah.